Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to continue our discussion on the IEC 61000-4-2 setup. This video is going to act as an overview, showing you how to put the individual components together to complete the setup, to hopefully save you guys hundreds, if not thousands of dollars. Okay, so should you guys need to be a little bit more immediate, we do rent as well as sell the individual components and the setup. Just keep in mind as we're walking through here, to reference the standard when you guys are manufacturing it, that way you're sure you're compliant. Okay, so taking a look here at our board behind us, we broke it down to three major components. That's going to be your ESD table, which is going to include your insulating foil and your horizontal coupling plane, followed by your vertical coupling plane and your stand. And the last major component we broke it down into is going to be your ground coupling plane, as well as your high voltage wire and resistors. So let's dive into this. Okay, here you'll find our ESD table. Taking a look at the bottom here, you will see that all wood structure holding up your horizontal coupling plane and your insulated foil. So if you guys want more information on the actual table construction, you can go ahead and check out our first video in the series. That's going to walk you through how we built our table. So that's out there for you. Today, however, we're mostly going to focus on your horizontal coupling plane and your insulating foil. So for our horizontal coupling plane, you will notice some minor scratches with the actual surface. We chose to use aluminum. Now, there was a lot of options out there, copper, steel. However, we chose to use aluminum because it is malleable. You'll see that with aluminum, you do scratch easier. However, it does allow you to drill through it. So that's going to be necessary kind of as you continue with your setup. You will notice right here, one of the connectors for the actual grounding cables. So again, one of the benefits of aluminum is that you can easily drill through it as opposed to some other metals that can be a little more difficult. So that's why we chose to use aluminum. With this size of this sheet here, you can just go ahead and reference the standard. Same with the foil. It's pretty straightforward as far as the actual sizing goes of the metal and the actual sheeting. So pretty straightforward there. So let's go ahead and let's take a look at that vertical coupling plane. Yeah, here you'll find our vertical coupling plane and our stand. So we're going to go ahead and start with the stand here. We're going to remove the vertical coupling plane. All right, so the stand, and there's a whole variety of different ways you go about making the stand yourself or buying it. However, we just chose to make it pretty straightforward here. We use the same concept as before with the table, wood pins, and then pieces of pine. So 2x4 out there, you can go ahead and check it out. You will notice that we got two guys right here, two pieces holding that for a coupling plane in. What we did is, for construction purposes, we got those pins put in there, clamped it all together, and let it sit, and you got a nice hold there. That vertical coupling plane isn't moving. So take a look here, you will notice another hole drilled here. And with all our setup, all the metal involved is all aluminum. So again, does scratch a little easier, but you are able to drill some holes in it. So this is going to connect to your ground coupling plane. It's going to be connected with your grounding cable. So we'll dive into that a little bit later. However, I just wanted you to be aware that it does connect right there. So all right, so that's about it with our vertical coupling plane and stand. Again, pretty easy, pretty straightforward. Doesn't take a whole lot of time to actually put that together. So let's go ahead and take a look at our ground coupling plane, as well as our high voltage wire and resistors. All right, so here you'll find our ground coupling plane. You'll see here we used five different sheets of aluminum. With all our setup today, we use all aluminum. So one of the good things about aluminum is it allows you to drill through it. You'll see here our connecting sheets are held together with little metal nuts and bolts there. So you will notice several of them. And again, when you guys decide what metal you want to go with, you can always test your ground coupling plane here. Get out your digital multimeter and just be sure you have a good connection there. So okay, so that's pretty straightforward. Depending on what metal you guys use, you might want to get multiple quotes. You can check out our blog. It shows you who we went with. For our metal, they are all over the United States and as well as international. So they're also a resource there for you. So taking a look here, you'll find our grounding cable next. These are pretty straightforward. The standard goes into great detail about this. So you got your high voltage wire, your resistors. Just be sure you guys are out there, you do get everything that's able to handle an ESD event. So that's what it's there for. Just be sure you're able to do that. So if you guys are looking for a quick solution, you guys can, of course, buy that from us. Otherwise, check out our blog. You guys can order the resistors, the high voltage wire, all that good stuff, and make it yourself. save yourself a considerable amount of money there too as well. All right, so why don't we go ahead, let's put everything together here and take a look at the whole setup. All right, here you'll find everything all assembled. You'll find your ESD table, your horizontal coupling plane, your insulating foil. Here you'll find your vertical coupling plane, your stand, and then below us is your ground coupling plane connected. All right, and we already have tested with our digital multimeter, everything is connected and we're good to go. We have connected here, you'll see from the bottom of our vertical coupling plane, our grounding cable with our two 470 kilo ohm resistors per wire. It's just another one right here. This is just grounding everything. And of course your ground coupling plane goes into your actual ground. So we'll talk a little bit more about the wire here real quick. So we actually had a little bit of trouble coming across these resistors. Pretty hard to come by, these high voltage capable resistors. So what I recommend is going through a company called Catic. You'll find that as well as more information about Catic and where we got our wire from in our blog. You can find the description. You'll find that in the description right below the video here. So go ahead and check that out if you guys are looking for a great place to pick up some resistors for this setup. Again, there's a lot of places that may sell these. However, depending on the amount you're looking for, you may not want to buy 100. So they're a great resource for that. We hope you guys learned a little bit about this IEC 61000-4-2 setup. Again, we do rent as well as sell these, so if your needs a little more immediate, feel free to give us a shout. We hope you guys maybe learned a little bit, and we look forward to hearing from you. Thanks.